we're told that the zeros of this function, this quadratic function right here, are integers. We want to find the sum of all possible values of a. Now, we know something about these zeros here. They're integers, so we know that we can write something like this. X minus r, x minus s, r and s are our zeros, equals x squared minus ax plus 2a. Now, if I multiply that out, I'm going to have a minus rx minus sx, and that's got to match up with my minus ax over there, so I'm going to have r plus s equals a. Multiply out the constant terms here, minus r times minus s is going to give me r times s, and that's got to be equal to 2a. Now what? Well, this at least tells me something. It tells me integer plus integer tells me that a is also an integer, so I'm going to go ahead and mark that right up here. A is an integer. I could keep going with these equations. Yeah, I could divide one by the other. That'll cancel out a, and I really care about a. I could just substitute and... Now, before I dive into dealing with now three variables, I'm going to take a step back. That'll work. Give it a whirl. That'll work just fine. I'm going to take a step back for a minute. Look back at this equation, this thing right, or this expression right here. It just has two variables. It has the one I care a lot about, too. It has that a. And we know something about the zeros. The zeros are the solutions to this equation. There's values of x that satisfy this equation. We know that those are integers. We really care about a. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to solve for a in this equation. I'm going to bring the terms with a over to the other side. Factor out the a, and divide. Divide by x minus 2. Now we know that's safe. X can't be 2, because if you stick 2 up here, the function's always equal to 4, so 2 is not a 0. We don't have to worry about x being 2. You do still have to worry about this. I don't like this fraction at all. It's got a variable expression on top and a variable expression on the bottom. Be able to handle this just fine. If I had a constant on the top, constant divided by x minus 2, I just look at the factors of the constant, we'd be good. Or if I could do some cancellation here, if I had some quadratic on top that had x minus 2 as a factor, be good as well. Now, I'm doing a little wishful thinking here. I wish I could cancel, or I wish I had a constant up there. What if I put these two wishes together? Wishful thinking, very powerful problem-solving strategy. What would cancel with our x minus 2? Well, if I had the top there was x squared minus 4. That would be nice. I'd get some cancellation. If I can't just turn it into x squared minus 4 magically, I have to put the plus 4 in there because I've got to keep this the same as that. But now I've got both of my wishes. They both come true. I've got my cancellation right there. I've got an integer divided by x minus 2 right there. So let's go ahead and simplify this first. X squared minus 4 over x minus 2. We know that x is not 2, so this simplifies to just x plus 2, and then I still have my plus 4 over x minus 2. Now again, we know that x has to be an integer because the zeros are integers, and we have also figured out that a has to be an integer. So when can I possibly have a and x both be integers? Well, that's only going to happen when this x minus 2 evenly divides the 4. So now I just have to look at the factors of 4, and we can pound out our possible values of a. So let's do that. We're going to be nice and organized here. I have to be organized. We've got x minus 2 is what we're dividing into 4. So we're going to look at our possible values of x minus 2. We'll back out x. And from that, we'll deduce a. So possible values of x minus 2, those are the factors of 4, positive and negative. Got to remember them both. So we're going to have 4, 2, or 1, negative 4, negative 2, or negative 1. Now we'll get our values of x for each of these cases. This is 6. 4 minus 2 is 2. 3 minus 2 is 1. In order to get a negative 4 there, I need to have, let's see, a negative 2 to start with. Negative 2 minus 2 is negative 4. 0 minus 2 is negative 2. And 1 minus 2 is negative 1. Now, my x's, I can stick them in here. We can get our values of a. So we put in 6 plus 2 is 8. Plus 1 is 9. Stick in 4 plus 2 is 6, plus another 2 is 8. Put in 3 in here, I get 5, plus 4 is 9. Now, I don't want to keep this in the list twice. I want the sum of the possible values of a. I don't want to add 9 in there twice. So I wipe that out real quick, put minus 2 in here, minus 2 plus 2 is 0, plus another negative 1, put a 0 in here, I get 2 plus a negative 2, 0, and I put a 1 in here, I get 3 minus 4, gives me a negative 1, and once again, I've already got negative 1, don't want to include that one again, so here are my possible values of A. 9 plus 8 minus the 1 gives us 16, and we're done.